Hi guys, this is Rodney with Jeepers Outpost. Today we're going to be replacing the center console subwoofer that come in many year models of the Jeep TJ. When I purchased my Jeep probably about 11 years ago, the subwoofer was broken. At that time I took it out, so therefore I will not be showing you how to remove the subwoofer, because again, mine's been out for over 10 years. But I will be doing the reinstall, and of course the reinstall is just in reverse order to do the subwoofer removal. So the first order of business was to find an affordable speaker. From what I've seen, I mean, the original equipment bought from the dealership, that could cost you over 100, maybe 200 bucks is one quote that I've actually seen. What I did do is I searched the internet, and there were some found one or two mid-range products that would work, not necessarily original equipment. What I did find on Amazon, I found this Goldwood. Part number is GW406D. It is a 6.5-inch subwoofer. It has 8-ohm. It is an 8-ohm subwoofer. It also has what you want to look for, no matter what product you buy. The Jeep TJ has a dual voice coil, and so you see it connects with four wires. Now this product I bought this thing for less than $20 on Amazon. So you guys, you know, that is an inexpensive choice. This is not a high-line speaker. I don't expect to get an amazing sound from this thing, but I do expect it to be a vast improvement over what I already have. All right, guys, so I got the speaker box out of the Jeep here. Now, first thing you're gonna notice, when you take this aftermarket speaker, which, like I said, is not designed for this application, try to slide it in the box, it fits in the hole nicely. I do see we will have to drill some new holes for the speaker, but you can see under here, there's about an inch of clearance left in here. You can get your finger under this thing, so it's not seating. The reason it is not seating is because you have these little fins here. I guess they're built for structural support. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna take a Dremel and we're gonna cut these things out to give the base of this speaker, which you see is rather large, we're gonna give this thing room to seat in there. And so we need about an inch of space. So we're gonna have this, it's gonna require a bit of cutting. I've heard of people using diagonal cutters. You know, that's great. Anything you have that you can cut these fins with, I mean, they're small plastic fins. So any tool that you have that you feel like you can cut these with, you know, that's great. Great to use. Anything to get them out of there. Today we'll be using a Dremel. Alright guys, well, what I have found while cutting on this with the Dremel is that some of these fins here, you can't actually get in there good with the Dremel. So what I'm using diagonal cutters just to snip these things. So I just snip them down, and then the rest of it I'm using to cut straight lines with the Dremel. Now keep in mind that basically the depth you're going to cut, I'm cutting all the way down as far as I can to the solid base here. What you have to do, we're going to need about an extra inch of space. We noticed that when we put sets of speaker up there. Once I had removed the fins, I noticed that there still wasn't enough room for my speaker to seat properly. Upon further inspection, I noticed there's an amplifier in the box, indicated by the yellow arrow. If you can move that amplifier over about a quarter of an inch, we can get the room that we need for the speaker. If you'll turn the box over, on the back side of the box, you'll notice a heat sink. The amplifier is attached to this heat sink. You'll need a Torx number 9 screwdriver, remove the three screws, and we'll move that box over just enough to get that speaker to seat properly. Okay, I've got the screws out, as you can see. And what we're gonna do, we're gonna take it does have a little gasket in there, so you'll have to break the seal on that gasket. And then I'm gonna slide this thing over to the edge of the box. I've got about a quarter inch of slack. So we're gonna slide it over there all far as we can get it to the edge. I want it seated against that edge. Then on the bottom, we'll slide the bottom down to it's about flush with the edge here. As you see, I no longer, my holes no longer line up. So I don't have any holes anymore. And the other thing is, you see I've exposed part of the opening. Now I'm no audio expert, I'm just not. But I believe that these boxes have to be kind of sealed if you want a good bass sound. So what we'll do is when we're finished with this job, we're gonna take some silicone and we will fill this hole up with silicone. Next thing we need to do, we need to drill some pilot holes. Now we use a 7/64 bit, 7/64 bit to drill some pilot holes. Doesn't have to be that size, guys. I believe in the right tool for the right job, but if you're like me, you know, if I ain't got the right tool, I don't have time to run down to the parts store and pick it up. So if you get something a little bit smaller, something a little bigger, as long as it is smaller than the screw, all we're doing is starting some pilot holes. So let's get that done. These are very easy to do. And if you're like me, I like to make sure these holes line up. So as I start that one, I'm going to go ahead and put a screw in there. We'll kind of snug that down, make sure this thing doesn't shift all over the place while I'm trying to drill my other holes. So I've got that first screw in there. Go ahead and drill the rest of the holes. Try to get them centered, of course. That wasn't so centered, but it'll work. These aren't difficult to drill at all. Now using my cordless drill and a number 9 torch bit, we'll go ahead and snug these things back down. Don't over tighten them. And we're using the exact same screws that came out of here. They will tighten right back down. So now we got that snug, so we're gonna flip it over and see if the speaker fits. All right, guys, let's drop the speaker in and see what we got. Yep, just dropped in. So that thing is flat all the way around. It's lying flat against that surface. So for the people to complain that this thing won't fit even though I cut it, that's what you gotta do. You gotta move that amp over just a little bit, probably a quarter of an inch all we gave it. So now it's mounted flush. So what we gotta do next, we're pulling the console back out of the Jeep. We're gonna plug this thing in before I screw it all down. We're gonna make sure that it works. You know, save yourself a lot of work. If you put it in there and something's wrong, you wanna know it before it's all cinched down. All right, first thing we're gonna do is get this console out of the Jeep. In the back seats here, they got a couple of cup holders. You usually have a little rubber seat, a little rubber thing that goes in the bottom of this. Mine is happily lost right now. There are two screws down here. We're gonna take those out. Those screws are both Torx 30. A T30 screwdriver, or if you happen to have that in a bit, you can do that with a bit. Now, of course, get it out a lot quicker. Okay, so we've got the back two screws out. So now we're gonna move up front. You're gonna remove this plastic cup holder. On the front of the console, you see another torque screw here. This torque screw will be a Torx number 9. So let's get that guy quickly out of the way. All right, guys, for that particular console, those three screws is all it's holding it in here. Now it's gonna be just a little wiggling and finagling to get this thing out. So you see this, it slides under here, so we're gonna have to work it back. Plus we got an emergency brake there, and then we gotta get it 22 seats. So we're gonna try to work it back. So we got it out there, and we're gonna work it out between the two seats. And there, so we got it out. And wow, what a mess we have. But what we're interested in right now is speakers, right? So there's my connection for a speaker. Let's plug this thing up and make sure it works. So this is the connection that comes out of the box. This plugs in to your amp and your speaker wires run through there. And this is the Jeep side of it here. So we'll plug these two guys together. All right, so we got that guy together. We got four wires. Like I said, this is a dual voice coil speaker. So, it doesn't matter which side you do this on. The wire's gonna go on either side. The red your red wire and black wire will need to go together. They're a pair. So red will go on the positive, black will go on the negative. Opposite side, the brown is going to go on the positive. And the gray will go on the negative. So let's see if this thing works. Okay, good deal. Speaker works. So let's take this thing back to the workbench. Let's cinch this speaker in here. We'll come back and we'll reinstall the box. Okay, we're getting ready to cinch the speaker down into the box. Now, as I've told you, the red and black are a pair. The red is the positive. The black is the negative. Now, if you see the male ends of the terminals here, they are uniform in size. It fits the red well. However, look how large this is. This is much larger. Now, you got one of two choices. You can, if you happen to have the female fitting that's a smaller in size, you can just clip this, solder it on there, crimp it on there, whatever you want, and you can get a better fit. What I'm going to do is I think we can get away. I'm going to use these pliers. I'm going to simply mash this thing a little bit and see if it won't give me a tighter fit. If it gives me a nice tight fit, we will just go with that. So let's make sure this is the negative. Wow, it's going to be a very tight fit, I guess. Maybe too tight. Had to use both my hands, so I had to put my camera down for a minute. But man, that thing's on there snug. So you can, if you want to, like I say, if you want to do it right, you can change the fitting on it. But I just cinched down on that with the pliers. This gives me a nice tight fit. So that's what we're going to do. So we'll go ahead, look at the red terminal on here, which is, again, the positive. And then we're going to cinch down on that gray one. Because again, it is a little large. The gray and the brown are a pair. And the gray is your negative in this case. And brown is your positive. Cool. Something I want to point out to you before we get this speaker in here. Now, with the male ends of the speaker neck connections, they stick out so far that you're going to have difficulty dropping this speaker into the hole in the box here. So what I want you to do is very carefully, once you have these things snugly connected, I want you to very carefully bend them back. Now guys, I can't stress enough, very carefully. You don't want to break these ears off, okay? If you do break them off, you're going to have to wind up soldering the wire on there. It's probably going to be the easiest fix. But anyway, very carefully bend them up. It's going to give them a little extra clearance. I'm going to do that over here. Bend, bend. Easy. This guy up. Just like that. So now it's opened up the space so I can get them in there easier. Like I've told you guys, I'm no expert at stereo systems installing these things, but I think if I'm right, it's important that you kind of seal this box up. It's going to give you the best base if you don't have where air can escape. So I just found this sitting in my toolbox. This is a little bit of insulation, very, very thin stuff. And what we're going to do, we're going to stick this all the way around the base of the speaker here to give it a good seal before we mount it in the box. Okay, I've got the foam around the base just for that seal. I'm going to drop this thing in here. Boom. Got a good flush seal. Got my wire out here like I ought to. All right. Let's screw this thing down. All right, guys. Same thing with the amp. We're going to have to drill new holes because this speaker is not the exact fit. So, again, we're going to use a 7/64 bit. And you're just going to go all around for each of your four holes and drill pilot holes, and we will reuse the same screws that came out of the original speaker. So let's get all those holes done. These are Torx number 9 screws. All right, so we got the speaker bolted down. When I got into the console, I discovered my front mounting bracket. So I remounted that. I just had to find some screws I had because I didn't have the originals. You got some clips, snap-in clips. No clip in here to hold your wires in place. These guys, when you remove it, there is a clip that's on there that you just have to destroy to get it off. That's the only way. You either break these things off or you'll take some diagonal cutters and cut those clips. But I don't think it's going to be that important to put a clip back on there if you can find the things, maybe at a hardware store. But the screws that go in here and the screws that go in the rear portion should be all you need to hold this thing down. So let's drop it in this box. Oh, one more thing before we forget. I told you guys we need to slip this hole on the backside of our amp where we slid it over. So let's take a little bit of silicone and fill that in. Finger and smooth that out so the hole was sealed up nicely. Let that dry a little bit. We're gonna go ahead and get this install going there. All right, now I've got the box back in here. We're going to, there's three screws that hold the speaker externally to the side of the console. We'll tighten these guys down real quickly. We've got our speaker back in the console. Now I want to get the console back in the Jeep. First thing I did is work it down 22 seats. Get about midway of the armrest and just kind of, you're going to just slide it back down in. Now, the wire that connects the Jeep to the speakers is rather short wire. This guy is right here. So, I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to show you guys this. I may have to kind of walk you through it. Now, so I'm feeling my way through this. So I just click that red tab. That secures this in place. All right, now we can put the console on down, get this thing bolted in. So once you get the console dropped down, you want to lift this up. It's almost like a Lego set. You lift this up, push it forward, and then push down on it. Make sure you got it in there securely. And the next thing we gotta do is line up the hole for the screw and get that thing going in there. Got the screw in there now. Kind of got it started. I'm going to leave it loose till we get these two back ones. All right, folks. Last part is we're going to put these last two bolts in. Hold our console in the back. Got those snug down. Take the little cup holder part and put it back in there. Snug this guy down. This is a Torx number 9. Got that snug down. Put my nasty cup holder back in place. Project is done, guys. All right, guys, let's see if this thing works. I think our subwoofer install is a success. Well, that's it, guys. For less than $20, we install the new subwoofer into the 2001 Jeep TJ console. Again, I picked that up on Amazon. It was less than 20 bucks. If you're a music connoisseur and you want something a little better quality, I think Rockford Fosgate had something I ran across in the $50 range. Also, I believe Quadratec carries a factory replacement for about $80. But if you want to go cheap, it produced a good sound for me. Again, I'm not a music connoisseur. I just want some good sound coming out of this Jeep. And this fit the bill for me. So maybe it'll work for you. If you like my video, be sure to like it, subscribe, and share it with your friends. Thanks for showing up and watch the video, guys. Hope I can help you. If you have any questions, y'all just shoot me an email at jeepersoutpost@gmail.com. Y'all have a great day.